Former President George W. Bush is expected to be discharged from the hospital tomorrow after undergoing a heart stent procedure. The 67-year-old had surgery in Texas after doctors discovered a blocked artery during his annual physical. A stent is a wire mesh coil that's used to prop open arteries. A spokesman says Bush is in high spirits and is eager to return home. All non-essential U.S. government personnel in Yemen have been flown out of the country amid fears of a potential terrorist attack. U.S. citizens living there are also being urged to leave. Officials say they intercepted a secret message from Al-Qaeda's leader urging militants to, quote, do something. A U.S. drone attack in Yemen killed four suspected Al-Qaeda militants overnight.
The U.S. soldier accused in the Fort Hood shooting rampage says he did it and he'll prove it. Major Nidal Hassan is representing himself in a court-martial which started today. Susan McGinnis tells us that means his own victims will have to answer to him.
U.S. Army soldier Nidal Hassan spoke softly but distinctly when he told jurors, "I am the shooter." Acting as his own attorney, Hassan also called himself an imperfect Muslim and apologized for mistakes he made. In its opening statement, the prosecution described Hassan's plan to kill as many soldiers as he could.
The moment that the rounds started hitting the ground, I felt that this was it.
When former Army Sergeant Howard Ray saw Hassan point a pistol at him, Ray instinctively reached for his own, but he was unarmed because of Army regulations.
So other than the military police, no one else was armed that day except one man.
That's right, and that was the shooter.
Ray shielded a fellow soldier from the gunfire.
I just said, I'll just take the rounds for her. That's all you can do.
Fortunately, the bullets missed. Ray is among those who may be called to testify here to face questions from their attacker.
The prospect of them being cross-examined by the person who shot them, it's turning into a circus.
Neil Scherr is an attorney representing some of the victims. He feels the shooting was preventable.
Hassan made no secret of what his beliefs were, and anybody following it could have predicted that something terrible was going to happen.
Hassan could face the death penalty if convicted. In Fort Hood, Texas, Susan McGinnis, KPIX 5.
We now have video of the man accused of killing three people during a township board meeting in rural Pennsylvania. Officers led a handcuffed 59-year-old Rocky Newell into a police station last night. They say he walked into the meeting in Ross Township and just started shooting. Two men tackled him, but Newell had already shot several people. He was arraigned today on homicide charges and other counts. Police say that he had this long-running dispute with town officials over his trash-filled property.
Tragedy for a Los Angeles family vacationing in Switzerland. A father was killed, three other family members injured in a hot air balloon crash. What's left of the balloon was strewn across the lawn. The passenger basket tipped over. The trouble happened this morning when the balloon hit power lines. It plunged 165 feet to the ground.
Tragedy.
And a sleepover turns tragic. These two boys were strangled by a 100-pound python in New Brunswick, Canada. 4-year-old Noah Barth and 6-year-old Connor Barth were sleeping at their friend's house, which is above a pet store. That store sells exotic reptiles.
Oh,
a python like this one escaped, slithering through the ventilation system and into the apartment.
Snake,
store
Mom.
Could face charges.
I don't know how you get on
about that. Are up this summer and not just
the
on
snake
TV.
The boy?
Researchers recently
I don't know, Mom.
In great white
but
shark
I can explain.
Off Cape Cod, which is Jaws country. But the worldwide shark population is actually at an all-time low. Marine scientists say the close encounters likely have more to do with us than them.
When you have more people out there looking or more people on or about the water, and when you have more eyeballs out there, you're going to get more shark sightings. You know, if anything, we're encroaching upon sharks' habitat more so than otherwise.
There have also been more sightings off the coast of California, but shark experts we spoke with say that's pretty normal this time of year as the animals do migrate from Hawaii to feed and breed.
Well, I guess it's mixed news for you. I guess if you like watching sharks, it hasn't exactly been like beach weather.
I'm a big fan of the minimum safe distance rule.
Yeah. Yep. Hopefully
that's
they are too.
There are lots of shark specials on many cable channels that you can watch.
Yes, you can have your close encounter on the TV.
Yes, and keep a nice safe distance away. Summer is keeping a safe distance away from us. Where is it? Chilly mornings, cloudy mornings, drizzle. We had 0.02 of an inch of rainfall.
in Ocean Beach today because of just drizzle that was falling. This is our live look from Mount Vaca, some wispy high thin cirrus clouds streaming on by. It's a beautiful sight. You've got the sunshine, but it is not warm outside. And finally, we're seeing some clearing over the Bay Bridge, looking over to more beautiful Oakland. We are looking at temperatures in Oakland, 66 degrees. San Francisco, a high today of 61. Look at Concord. With the sunshine, you're only 71 degrees. Livermore, 74. These temperatures are running anywhere from 10 to 18 degrees below average. That is significant. San Jose, South Bay, look at your highs the past few days. 74, 73, and today, 73 in San Jose. Your average is 82. So something's got to be going on to not only get us cold, but keep us cold for this long. Today, the 11th straight day. Well, I'm showing you the something on your television screen right now. It's a big area of low pressure, kind of in the perfect spot to give us the chilly weather, because a westerly component to the wind will grab the ocean influence, but it's a southwest wind that really gets things chilly and cloudy and drizzly. That's exactly the type of wind we're getting when this low pressure area is just off to our west. So as long as this continues, our forecast will stay cloudy and drizzly in the morning and chilly even with the sunshine in the afternoon. And tomorrow, the map looks a whole lot like the map I showed you 24 hours ago, because not much is changing. If anything changes over the next couple of days, it'll be an area of low pressure getting closer to us and enhancing the onshore flow. So tomorrow and Thursday, we will stay well below normal, likely all the way until Saturday. That'll be when we begin to bump up temperatures. And you might not notice the change in the weather until Sunday. We'll be gaining a few degrees every day, but it'll be Sunday before we get anywhere close to normal. We'll see temperatures well below average tomorrow and all the way into and through the weekend. So look at San Jose tomorrow, another day with a high of 73. Livermore, a dozen degrees below average at 76. And downtown San Francisco, kind of par for the course, mid-60s for you. Mountain View, 72. Fremont, 68. Redwood City, 74. Cloudy start, sunny finish. Concord, only 75 tomorrow. Antioch, 76. Fairfield, 78. Benicia, only 68. Alameda, your high tomorrow, 64. San Rafael, upper 60s for you, 70 for Sonoma. And even down to the 80s for Lakeport, Clear Lake, and Ukiah, typically in the mid-90s this time of year. Then we begin this very slow process. We'll gain 2 degrees on Friday, a couple more as we head toward the weekend. By Sunday, yeah, we're back to the mid-80s and right around 70 near the Bay, and we'll likely gain a few more degrees from the top of next week. It's going to be probably another 6 to 10 days until we get back to a pattern that we would call normal for this summer. Some people love it. I'm getting a lot of emails saying, you know what? We don't mind the high of the heat.
Yeah.
It is pretty good. Especially for us.
I want to feel a little bit like summer. It's, you know,
because August. Kids are back to school in like 2 weeks.
I know. They want to be in the pool.
Exactly. Thank you. Turning the tables on frustrating customer service agents.
I feel vindicated right now because I feel that I stood up for myself.
But before you do what she did, you need to know the rules or you could end up behind bars. We'll explain next.
And we're just 2 days away from 49er football. The defending NFC champs take on the Broncos Thursday, 6 o'clock, right here on KPIX Live.